The answer is we don't need to resort to proof by intimidation in this case. We can prove this by dividing by pi. So what happens when we divide by pi? Well, the left side, we have this product of primes. So we're going to still have this product of primes now removing pi from the product, plus the 1, which is now divided by pi. And we divided pi out of pi times q, so we have q here. This is our contradiction. Q is an integer. This is an integer. Pi cannot be 1 because it's a prime. It must be some integer 2 or greater. So that means that this is not a whole number. So there's no way we could get an integer as q by adding something that's not an integer to an integer. Thus, we've shown that there are infinitely many primes by contradicting our assumption that there was a limited set of primes. This isn't quite enough to be happy that we can generate large prime numbers when we need them. We need to know how dense the primes are and how to find a large prime.